Back to the breaking news that we brought you at the top of this newscast. Longtime WDSU newsman Alec Gifford passed away tonight. WDSU anchor Norman Robinson takes a look back on Gifford's career here in New Orleans and at WDSU.
For generations, he was Mr. New Orleans television news.
Good evening, everyone. This is Alec Gifford reporting.
Born and raised in the Crescent City, the son of a newspaper reporter, Gifford's roots run deep in journalism.
It's high noon in the Crescent City and time to catch up on the news with a lot of people on Midday, 60 minutes of information and fun.
Time now for the news, and for that, here's Alec Gifford.
Thank you, Terry. Good afternoon, everyone.
Alec began his career at WDSU in 1955. It was a journey that would take him around the world to the national stage as a network correspondent for NBC News and back to his beloved New Orleans. His legacy of reporting is legendary. The desegregation of New Orleans schools in the 1960s.
The New Orleans public school system has lost another round in its attempt to preserve segregation.
Hurricane Betsy in 1965.
Every station in New Orleans, including WDSU TV and the other two TVs, signed off the air. We couldn't go on anymore. The only station left on the air was WDSU Radio. And I did a lot of the coverage reading copy that had been handwritten for me by candlelight.
Were people panicking back in 1965, Alec?
Oh, I'll say they were, because, you know, 68 people were killed in New Orleans that day. They drowned in the attics of their homes. That's how high the water was in the Chalmette area and Carolyn Park area of St. Bernard Parish. It was a horrible, devastating storm.
The infamous sniper incident in 1973, when an angry, avowed Black Panther opened fire from atop the former Howard Johnson Hotel in downtown New Orleans, killing 10 people and wounding 13 others.
You're hearing automatic weapons fire as well as single shots. Extremely automatic weapons fire.
With our own Alec Gifford, who flew with them to Havana. Hello, Alec.
Alec would also take us on his journeys around the world, visiting Germany in the 60s.
There are two things about Berlin that are immediately apparent to anyone visiting this city for the first time. One of these is this wall that divides the city. The other is the River Spree, which unites it.
In Israel in the 70s.
As far as the Israelis are concerned, Jerusalem simply is not a negotiating point. As one Israeli put it, we will give Jerusalem back to the Arabs just as soon as you give Manhattan back to the Indians.
Then there was the memorable trip to Japan as that country was preparing for the 1985 World's Fair.
Dixieland jazz is very big in Disneyland and Tokyo, and all over Japan too, for that matter. And although something may get lost in translation from the genuine, authentic New Orleans original, that doesn't seem to matter to the people of Japan and to the people who come to Disneyland to soak up that Dixieland jazz.
Alec was the quintessential newsman. His interests ran the gamut. He was at home reporting on everything from features to politics.
Peggy Wilson is an interesting candidate.
Come on.
Tom Watson is an interesting candidate.
Get real, Mr. Mayor. Who are the two people that are most likely to challenge you in this runoff, in your opinion?
Oh, I think those two candidates have as much shot as anybody.
Mr. Mayor, you're yanking my chain, as they say, right?
Alec Gifford, an icon among reporters in New Orleans, broadcast or print. His legacy lives on here at WDSU in the Alec Gifford Newsroom, where this lifetime achievement plaque is on permanent display.
Again, Alec Gifford passed away just right before this newscast tonight. He was 85 years old. I wish Norman Robinson could be next to me to share some of his memories tonight. But we do have Margaret Orr here next to me on the other side tonight. She worked with him for a long time as well. I didn't have the pleasure of working with him, but I've seen him around and have talked to him briefly, but you have a lot of experience with
Amazing him. Man. I mean, he knew the city of New Orleans so incredibly and covered it. I mean, he was there when I was a child. He's about the age of my father, so I grew up, of course, watching him. But I did apply to him one time. He worked at Channel 8 at the time, and he said, Margaret, I really like you. You just need a dash of Tabasco. And, you know, that really stuck with me.
He had a
major, major influence on my life. The Breakfast Edition, the World's Fair, a couple of things I worked with him doing. And advice that he gave me. I mean, he'd take me aside and say, Margaret, be nice to the people you meet on the way up. You're going to meet him on the way down.
Obviously a man with a lot of sayings and a lot of good advice. I mean, got here in 1955 at WDSU and covered presidential inaugurations, went to cover the Pope. Mm-hmm. I mean, he covered everything
over all those years. He truly knew this area. One of the things that he said impacted him more than anything besides Betsy was Audrey. Audrey was a terrible hurricane, and he said, he called me Meg, I just couldn't believe I saw all of these cows that were dead. You know, it was just complete and utter devastation. That had a major impact on him.
And when you know you've made an impact on people in general is when you hear his name so often referenced in our newsroom. Not only do we have the plaques on each end of the newsroom with his name on it, but you hear people still talking about him today, and he retired from the station in 2006, so still a big presence all these years later.
We all loved him.
All right, well, we'll be back after this quick break with Margaret's weather. Again, Alec Gifford passed away tonight at the age of 85.